Okay, so that's yourself. Mr. Chairman, panel of judges, appellate timekeeper, members of staff, fellow debaters, students, ladies and gentlemen. The motion before the House is that quality secondary education without technical education is a mirage for national development. And I, Mr. Babeli, the principal speaker from the Selma Senior High School Council, stand for the motion. Mr. Chairman, to start with, it is necessary for the House to be educated on few terms in the motion for better understanding. The word mirage, according to Oxford Advanced Learning Dictionary, is an condition of which that cannot make happen because it is not realistic. This means that national development with only quality education without technical education is impossible. And this is true, Mr. Chairman. One can ask, what is secondary education and technical education? Mr. Chairman, according to Wikipedia, the free encyclopedia, secondary education covers two phases on the international standard classification of education skill. Level 2, which is the junior secondary education, is considered the second and final phase of physical education. Level 3, which is the senior secondary education, is the base stage for tertiary education. Mr. Chairman, typically, secondary schools offer programs to prepare students for university or college, while technical schools offer education to prepare students or individuals for employment and business or specific trade and career. Secondary schools also help students to think critically and effectively, and also address societal and individual responsibility. Mr. Chairman, according to Sita Suman Igowaya, a lecturer in mechanical engineering department of MS University of Baroda in India, volume 6, issued on 3rd May 2017, I quote, the acquisition of technical training enables students to get their upper skill in order for production of goods and services. Mr. Chairman, how many can secondary education without technical education, which helps individuals and prepares them for university or college, able to develop a nation without technical education? Mr. Chairman, 50 years ago, I'm not sure any of you here would have loved to travel to China. China as of then was a poverty-stricken country. China's per capita income was one third of that of sub-Saharan Africa. Mr. China, can you imagine this? But today, what we see, there has been magnificent changes in China. Now China can boast of being an industrial powerhouse and also a production hub of the world. Did you know that 50% of the industrial goods are now being produced in China? Mr. Chairman, one would ask, how did this happen? It's interesting to say that the development began since China introduced industrial automation in the economy. China now has focused on technical education as part of their educational curriculum. China can also claim of surpassing the US in 2010 in that industrial field. Mr. Chairman, today China has the world's largest educational and technical or vocational education system with 11,300 schools, in which over 10,000 students complete each and every year. With this, you can all attest to the importance of technical education to a nation. This is what has brought China this far. Mr. Chairman, I'm of the view that a nation is equivalent to nothing without technical education. Mr. Chairman, according to Albert Hofstra, ancient of the 21st century will not be those who cannot read and write, but rather those who can learn or learn and relearn. According to educational thinker, African Education Watch, secondly, education helps students acquire knowledge. But with technical education, one gets employable skills or the bypass roads in order to translate into production for self-employment. This can also help reduce unemployment rates, since self-employment is going to be dominant over the country. Mr. Chairman, I will now have the view that with technical education, one can be able to earn an income as about 100,000 out of 110,000 students who complete the university, only 10% have secure jobs after national school. How can this be, Mr. Chairman? This is very disgusting. Each and every year, over 400,000 complete secondary schools, but they just come home to stay because there's no way or job opportunity. Mr. Chairman, I declare my stance that technical education is the must-have for national development. Mr. Chairman, panel of judges, a paid timekeeper, members of staff, fellow debaters, students, ladies and gentlemen, having exhausted all my points, focusing on the need of technical education, and in addition to secondary education for national development, I draw a challenge to anyone who has in mind that technical education is meant for the poor or unintelligent society. I beg to differ. Technical education requires more community skills and abilities. Mr. Chairman, if anyone has a reason to enroll his award to a school, look no further. Choose the secondary technical school. More precise, it's your master high technical school. The award is our assurance.